The internet continues to be a breeding ground for all sorts of false information about COVID-19. CBS 17 consumer investigator Steve Spracia debunks another one in tonight's coronavirus myth segment.
Sometimes myths come back again and again, swaddled in new wrapping paper like a badly regifted item. Such is the case about one myth regarding face coverings, which has been brewing for a while now.
Here's the myth that you can use a coffee filter as an effective mask to keep the COVID-19 at bay. This myth got wide play the other night on Stephen Colbert's A Late Show at Home when guest Matthew McConaughey demonstrated his homemade face coverings.
Here's how. So you lay down your favorite bandana, unfold it like so. Get your trusty coffee filter that you had on the go. Get your two rubber bands. Roll one down one end like this. Roll the other one down this end like that. Fold them over like so. Grab a hold, and you're good to go.
After that segment aired, I was contacted by a clinical researcher who specializes in viruses who was aghast that coffee filters would be suggested as a material for face coverings. Now, previously, we warned you against using paper towels as a homemade face covering because they don't effectively block the virus. The researcher said that coffee filters, like all paper products, attract moisture, and that's dangerous because you want to avoid anything that grabs or absorbs a liquid. The CDC says that homemade face coverings are supposed to help stop virus-filled droplets from reaching you. But a coffee filter or other paper product will absorb moisture, bringing those droplets closer to your mouth, defeating the purpose of the face covering. Now, Melita, a coffee filter company, warns on its website against using coffee filters, saying the coronavirus is smaller than the pores in its filters and they do not provide the protection required. The CDC and others say that several layers of cloth folded upon itself are the most effective makeshift face covering, but they should only be used once, then washed in hot soapy water to remove any contamination before using again.
So, though this coffee filter myth has been percolating on the internet for a while, you need to get rid of it the same way you would with used coffee grounds. Working for you, I'm consumer investigator Steve Spracia.